screams really loud. It's like, okay, stop saying, but then this time I wasn't thinking, stop saying, I was thinking, keep saying, because it was so, relaxing. This is harder than it looks, by the way. It's not that easy to, force an, story. noticing it's really slowing down with every update. Yeah, it is, so I need a new one soon. Like, yeah. I don't like how it's getting there, but I don't want to necessarily buy a new one. Right now, I'm just kind of chilling and vibing with life. I don't really, like, care for the same things I used to. Like, it's so hilarious because there will be people messaging me or telling me about something that they think I care about, but I really don't anymore. And it's almost like, I guess in a way, not to sound rude, but I don't know what gives certain people the right to think that they can kind of tell me what to do with my life. That sometimes with certain people, and you just have to let go of that toxic behavior. It's like, no, I'm a grown adult. You're younger than me, most likely. And relevance or not that I have more experience than a person, I still feel like, ever feel certain people come and go in your life, and they just, every time they enter your life, it's just like worse, or they're the same, and they never choose to change. So, I'm more careful with people now than ever before, more distrusting than ever before. But I feel like pain has taught me that, I don't want to go through the same ordeals or situations, and, I'm protective of my heart more and my soul. For someone that is like that. I guess in a way it's ironic because I can have controlling behavior to an extent, but then others have controlling behavior to where they try to tell others what to do. So it's like, I'm not necessarily that kind of person. Sure, I'm human. I have told people what to do before, but if someone tells me no or stop, stop, you know. I understand boundaries now, but I don't know what gives certain people the right to be pretending they're like understanding you or knowing you when they really don't, or like when someone criticizes you or comments and says you're being a certain way or you are coming across a certain way. It's really agitating, aggravating actually. It pisses me off a lot because it's like, no, honey, you don't know me. You don't know who I am. You haven't even spoken to me in years and years and years. And then you show up randomly and you pretend like you know me and like you're here to be my friend, but then you criticize me. It's like, no, bye. Goodbye to you. I used to be desperate. I used to crave these friendships. police over this person and let them go. It's not worth it. You deserve better, trust me. And you're gonna feel so much more at ease and a relief once they're gone. So I would say sometimes, you know, there's like energy vultures, vampires. I know I've been spiritually attacked lately, but I used to ask even people to pray for me sometimes. But honestly, please don't unless you're spiritually protected and armored up, because I have strong forces on my team, and because I do, I have equally opposing forces that are very strong. So when I get spiritually attacked, it can last a long time, weeks, months. Like, yeah, don't pray for a person unless you're armored up, because you don't know what those forces can attack you with for praying for that person. So like, yeah, I'm even precautious who I pray for nowadays, honestly, because there were certain people I did, and that was like, I noticed I started getting attacked because of that. So I wasn't armored up or protected in my spiritual team enough. So you don't know who has what guardian watching over, or who has what ancestor. So be very precautious, and who is malicious and who is good. You don't know until you test it in the realm of the spirit. So I would say be on the lookout for that. And yeah, it so reminds me of a family member that asked me to pray for them, and I never did, and they ended up passing away like shortly after, and I regretted it, but part of me said like it's good sometimes you forgot to, or didn't at the time, or just, you know, it slipped your mind, because you don't know what could happen to you if you tried to. So but prayer is powerful, I believe in it, but I learned that recently that you have to be careful who you pray for, because it can actually influence you. Everything's energy, even if you don't believe in the power of prayer. You know, there's in this universe equally good and bad force, yin and yang, it's a balance. So where there's a lot of good in a person, there's also a lot of bad. Trying to rebel or oppose that force, so please be aware of that. Okay. Alright, so especially a person that's been through a lot, you do want to be gentle with them, because that can make a person hypersensitive too, is the extreme polarity of forces that are repelling and each other. That's why it's important to stay grounded and centered, and to, you know, harmonize those oppositions.